I'm Arun Kumar from TuffSoot. Well, we all been talking about all this, anti-dumping, safeguard duties, and custom duties, and all these things. Just for a moment, think about, has it really helped our Indian industry? Okay, do we have, first of all, I think somewhere down the line, this DCR component, what they were talking about all through, got diluted. So when we say DCR, it is a domestic content requirement. So when you don't have the ingot, where is the question of DCR coming into the picture? So, I mean, like, a lot of things have been left out when they come with the regulations, you know. And whom are we trying to help out? When you talk about all these duties which are being levied, whom are we trying to help out? We have got only a handful of manufacturers, and they also depend upon other countries for their raw material. Are we really helping them out? So the government needs to think about this. How much of hurdles can you put across through the solar industry? It is a growing industry. I think we should remove all these hurdles, let them grow for another 10, 15 years, and then whatever duties and whatever structure you want, levy, they are ready to pay. But not at the early stage, you know, when the industry is growing, putting all these duties is going to reduce. It is 175 gigawatt, what we have been talking about. I don't think so it's achievable with this sort of way in which the government is and the policies are running through. So that is my take on these duties and policies which are being often changed. Another thing is, in this entire gamut of these duties and anti-dumping duties and tax structures, somewhere down the line we are missing on something which is important, is the quality. So I don't think so there's a much emphasis has been put through in policies on quality, safety, the way the plants have been built in India. Most of the plants have started degrading. We don't find any plants now with the peak performance what they were 5 years or 6 years down the line. So what's happening, the government should think about that. So we in fact brought in, from whatever knowledge we have gained, we've told the government, you have said, okay, IEC certified modules, IEC certified inverters, then you have an ISI certified cables, everything is certified, okay? But when it comes to the plant, what sort of a discipline you have in building the power plants? Is there a standard for building a power plant which will take care of quality, safety, and also the risk? So we have seen plants which have been submerged when there's a heavy downpour. We have seen many plants, degrading because of PID issues. And a lot of issues are started cropping up, and people are started in a hurry to sell off the plants. And many people are there to buy the plants also. So there is something missing when we talk about these things. We started fighting with the government and all, but the larger part of it is totally missing. Now, at least from now onwards, we need to look at what is quality, safety, and risks, and bring about a drastic change in the way we build these plants. That is my view.
Thank you. Hello all. I just take 1 minute to introduce myself. I am Avinash. I represent Power One Microsystems Private Limited, about 27-year-old company based out in Bangalore, basically into power electronics and power solutions, past 2 decades, more than that. So we are solar EPC company, we are solar inverter manufacturer in on-grid and hybrid segment. So coming back to this session where we are, I want to touch, most of the people have been here, panelists have been speaking about policies, regulations, and all the duties, and the concentration has been only in C&I segment. There is a untapped market, where residences, we are not approaching the residents or a domestic market, where we have achieved only 10% of the target in Karnataka. It is hardly 200 megawatt or something, which covers most of, again, industrial rooftops. When we basically look at the rooftops of a residential segment, then there is a lot of opportunity there, but the lack is, there is no approach to a customer there. You cannot go and find a, we cannot find a customer, we can't educate them. There is, I feel there is a lack of, way to approach them, make them understand where is it really hindering to achieve that target or untap the market where there is a lot of potential. So when we talk about these regulations and all, it's again talks about on-grid solutions. You think of on-grid solutions, letting them connecting to the grid, export, and you know. And then there comes when rooftop or residential segment understand the proper solution and use of its applications for their day-to-day usage of power, then we have a lot of opportunities there. And going forward, there are hybrid inverters in the market, which will allow you to consume the power or utilize the power for your day-to-day needs on for your residential equipments or loads, and then excess generated power can be thought of exporting. This could be another huge thing, as everybody talking about storage in a big way. Storage in a big way might take, you know, a lot of time in India, and storage of 1 megawatt, 2 megawatt stuff, but let's think of a storage in a smaller way in a residential segment, where you can store the power or consume the power directly from the solar during daytime, and then think of exporting the power if you are really generating excess power out of your roof. First, self-sustaining, consume the power as much as possible, and then think of, you know, exporting the excess power. So this might take on considering the residential or domestic segment. Thank you.
Yeah, so good evening, everyone. My name is Rahul Khatri, and I'm from DuPont India. I don't know how many of you know DuPont. Just a brief introduction about DuPont. So it's a US-based company, one of the oldest, I think, in this room, more than 200 years old now. And it's mainly into supply of materials for, I think, almost all industries, including solar. I would like to kind of, again, touch upon the point that Mr. Arun kind of shared a short while ago with regard to performance of PV modules in the field. DuPont has been involved in a lot of field studies since last 10 years. And I think that is the time when the PV, changes in PV started to happen, because that is the time when people started to look at PV as a viable option to replace fossil fuels to generate a clean source of energy. And that is where people started to kind of install PV projects across the globe. And because of cost pressures, because of demand to kind of reduce the cost of solar energy, a lot of changes started to happen in the PV module. So I think, again, with regard to a lot of challenges which we are seeing and which we are discussing, I think, in all forums, I keep on hearing about safeguard duties. I think since last 3 years, I'm hearing about that. And still, there is no conclusion around that. Government went ahead and kind of imposed duties. And they will go ahead and impose other duties if they see it's going to help. The thing is that we hardly speak about how the plants which are installed. And in India itself, I think the PV program started in 2011. And then some of the plants would have now been in the field for more than 8 to 9 years. So how are those plants are performing? Talking about technology changes, but are we sure that those plants which are installed around 10 years ago are going to perform for 25 years? So that is, again, one of the biggest, I think, question marks. And again, we'll give you some data which shows that it's a very big concern as well in terms of the performance of the plants for 25 years. So I don't know how many of you know the IIT Bombay releases this report. What they do is that they go in the field, inspect modules, do the power analysis of modules, and they kind of generate these reports every 2 years. So I think last report which they had published showed a very alarming figure in terms of degradation rates on an average in the range of around 1.8 to 1.9%. How much we dial in our calculation? 0.7, 0.8%. So that is a very alarming number. And then they have recently published a new report. I think it's going to come out very soon. They have published some articles around that. In the current study, they increase the number of plants, they increase the number of modules, and still it's coming to around 1.4 to 1.5% on an annual basis. So again, I think this is something very critical concern or very critical point that we need to consider. And then again, why it's happening. So as I told you, we also do all this kind of analysis. And I will again throw some numbers. So in terms of global, so we do on a global level because we have teams across the globe, and we have been able to fortunately see some of the very old plants which are as old as maybe 35 years. So we have been able to kind of understand the performance of modules one in different climatic conditions based on age, based on the material that has been used in the module. Because module looks same, all modules look same, especially with regard to crystalline silicon, but the materials which are used in them could be different. And that is what Vinesh said, that changes are happening in the last 10 years. Mainly the changes have happened with regard to module materials. Yes, we have done a lot of good work with regard to increasing efficiency. But sadly, we have, I think, made a lot of compromise also with regard to materials. So yes, you are getting now more power output from the modules. But whether they're going to work in the field for 25 years, again, there's a big question mark. So again, with regard to numbers, So DuPont has done inspection of more than 2 gigawatt across the globe. And in India itself, we have done around 700 megawatts. In terms of modules, we have seen more than now 5 million panels and age from between 1 to 25 or 35 years. And again, give you some numbers, especially with regard to India, in terms of the defect rate that we have seen in different components, cells, which is the basic or which is the main component, has shown defects in more than 50% of the modules that we had inspected across the age groups. If you talk about backsheets, around 12 to 13% of the modules are showing backsheet issues. If I just look at the data of the modules which are 5+ years old, the defect rate in backsheet increases from 14% to 35%. So it's not about the modules if they're working well in first 2 or 3 years or first 5 years, they have to work well in next 25 years as well. This is a very alarming, I think, concern, and quality is something which is in your control. You can't control safeguard duties, you can't control policies, you can't control a lot of other things, but DISCOMs, I think we were discussing on DISCOMs as well, but we do can control quality. And this is again, can be a big factor which can have an impact on your returns. Something which is in your hand as a manufacturer or as a developer, I think this is something which you can control. And one of the things which we have, or one of the measures which we have seen could be very helpful is understanding more about modules, understanding more about materials, and having a specification. I think maybe even a very small company to go and buy a module, a laptop or a phone, you have your own specification. You're buying modules, there's hardly any specification other than IC certification. I will come to IC certification as well. So I think that is the one thing which as a developer you have to do, that understand what is going to work, where exactly the risks are, and based on that you have to have your own specification. And as a manufacturer as well, again, since now you're giving more warranties, you're giving 12 years warranty with regard to manufacturing, you're giving 25, 30 years warranties with regard to power, you have to be much more careful. Either, again, once the issue comes, you will just kind of go away, will not honor warranty, but as a good manufacturer, and that is what, starting manufacturing in India is one, but can you kind of sustain that? A lot of Chinese manufacturers which were, I think, tier one, around 10 years back, you don't hear the name of the same manufacturers now. So it's not only about having a manufacturing setup in India or anywhere else. You have to sustain that, and can sustain it only if you have a product which is going to work for 25 years. So coming to quality standards, again, one of the topics of the panel discussion. So I think there is a clear indication. So now we have BIS in India, which is exact copy of IEC. So one of the things which is very clear is that at least government of India understands that there is a quality issue in India, and that is why they went ahead and introduced this certification. I think the intent is right. Yes, they understand that there is an issue with regard to quality, and they have to do something. But whether that intent or the measure is going to help anyone, answer is big no. Again, sorry to say, other than labs in India, nobody else is going to get benefit. With regard to manufacturers, now you have ALMM, which is again something kind of a bottleneck which need to be kind of cleared if you want to sell your modules in India. But it's not helping any way to improve quality of PV modules. Still, same modules are coming in India, it's just certification which you are adding. You have to send your modules to a lab. If you don't have, you can't sell your modules. So it's just creating a lot of bottlenecks in terms of supply chain. Otherwise, in terms of quality, it's not helping. If you actually want to kind of use this as a tool to improve quality of PV modules, I think in USA they have a very different way. Yes, they have this US certification, they don't have IEC. But beyond that, again, as a developer or as a financial institution, they go ahead and ask for some PVL certifications. PVL again is a lab-like TOV, but then they go beyond what IEC does. Recently, they have added a test which is going to certify or test the backsheets being used. And the reason being is that a lot of complaints with regard to backsheet failures are coming in from the market, especially plants which are more than 5 years old. Recently, there was an article which I saw yesterday, again, an independent article, and then a plant which was installed in 2016. The entire plant is showing a very high power output loss, and one of the main reasons is because of poor backsheets. So this is what is happening, and yes, we are talking about technology, but again, if you're not going to use the right material, even if you use the best of technology, the module is not going to work. So I think this is the learning. I think we have to kind of get our idea about quality much better. I think discuss quality in more detail. Typically, we discuss quality in very vague term. It has to be more specific. It has to be more detailed. And again, as I told you, we do a lot of these kind of analysis in India. We don't charge anything for that because we think it's a learning exercise for us. It's not about denigrating the names. We don't share any names with regard to manufacturers or the suppliers. It's more about understanding what is working and what is not, and based on that, what we can learn, so that at least in future, we can improve the quality of the modules that we're buying. We know how we have to select a better quality module. So this is what I want to share, and I think that if you're interested, you're going to work with us in terms of maybe if you have plants which are old, where you're seeing issues, we would be very happy to kind of work with you, maybe in case there's a need for us to visit the plant, we will do that, and come out with the possible root cause and what can be done to mitigate those issues.
Yeah, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rajesh Singh. I represent the company Renovsys. We manufacture solar module and also three main components of solar panel: cell, backsheet, and EVA, EVA encapsulant. Manufacturing unit for EVA and backsheet is in Bangalore, whereas module is in Hyderabad. Module and cell are in Hyderabad. Okay. Taking again thread from Mr. Arun's discussion, why we need any dumping duty or safeguard duty or any government support. Let us see the manufacturing setup in India and also what is happening in China, because unfortunately China has been our reference point for looking at economy of scale. If you see in India, the number of module manufacturer having capacity more than 500 megawatt are just handful. Even you don't need all five fingers probably to count them who are having 500 megawatt and above. If you see any maybe medium level capacity in China is at least gigawatt. So they are going from gigawatt, 2 gigawatt, 3 gigawatt. They always talk in gigawatt, we always talk in megawatt. And if we talk of gigawatt, maybe you need two fingers. So there's a lot of difference in equal playing field. Scale of economy created out of the scale is going to be a big determining factor to make Indian companies sustainable. So this is the one reason. We started manufacturing EVA first, then we came up in backsheet. I'm trying to give some pain of manufacturing unit in India, because everybody has been talking on rooftop, ground mounted, from installation side of the business. But in manufacturing, we could manufacture components, we could manufacture solar modules. But in this fraternity itself, someone was in the second session, I think someone was saying, who is making money in India? Descom is not making, EPC people are not making, developer are not making, definitely manufacturer are not making, then where is the money going? This is a matter of concern, real matter of concern. Our manufacturing capacity, I'm trying to give our pain connecting with the problem in the industry and how we can tackle, how a country can become self-sustainable over a period of time, because solution cannot come in short term. It has to be a long-term drawn process. We are the biggest manufacturer of EVA, having capacity of 1.6 gigawatt. If you tell in China that I have capacity of 1 gigawatt, they will laugh. What you are talking? The minimum is 20 gigawatt. First EVA has got capacity of 50 megawatt or maybe more, if someone knows accurate figure. So in terms of even backsheet capacity, we have 3 gigawatt and they have 20 gigawatt minimum. So these are factors which compels Indian manufacturer to at least have an equal playing field, getting some subsidy, getting some incentive from government to create that conducive environment and live themselves. In fact, Mr. Narasingha Rao in the morning, first he said you don't need duty exemptions. In fact, he was right in one of the aspects. But subsequently, he also said you need to be self-sufficient. Country has to be self-sufficient. What is the value chain in India? Only we have manufacturing of module or little bit component. Module manufacturing and component. Where is ingots, polysilicon, MG? Everything is coming from abroad. So when will time come when at least people start thinking that India can become self-sufficient going forward? Maybe a decade plan, even a decade, we have to live longer than a decade. So we should start thinking from today. We have some, our capacity is 710 megawatt nameplate for module manufacturing. We manufacture around 550-600 megawatt, but we know how much pain we take to contain our overhead cost. We try to calculate the second place of decimal of the manufacturing cost, because cell cost is fixed. All glass, frame, cable connectors, all are coming from abroad. If we buy at say 1 rupee, someone with very high volume will buy 99 paise. It's only the difference. Only make what makes one company to other company to differ is how efficient they are in controlling their overhead cost. And that is only few percent of total cost of the module. So entire thing of cost structure of module dependent on only RMC. And RMC is in not in country's hand, in somebody else's hand. So this is important. According to our estimate, someone said already in the audience, I think, we have some safeguard duties starting from 25% came to 20, now 15. Then industry is thinking of going for anti-dumping duty. Let me tell you, if you don't have these, probably would have shut down long back. If I say again, from our own perspective, we got anti-dumping duty in EVA a year back, last March 2019 we got. If this had not come, we would have stopped by previous year, by November last, because absolutely we were making losses. In spite of having very efficient supply chain, very efficient machinery, we have European machines. Maybe people are trying CapEx versus CapEx of a cheap machine versus a high quality machine. The high quality machine from Germany costed us 3 times more than the machine which we would have bought from maybe China. But any business needs a J curve. If you see the J curve, the investment is this much, but if you are more efficient in terms of wastage control, productivity, overhead cost control, probably in long term you gain better. So we believe in high quality machines. We always try to buy the best machinery possible from the world. And that is what we did. And in spite of being so efficient in manufacturing, we were in loss for EVA. And then probably we thought, let's knock the door, and we got some support. So this is important for India as a manufacturing country. And now we are going to make in India and then assemble in India. These things only happen when money speaks. We can talk of a lot of things, but ultimately, if business makes money, then only it will sustain. Otherwise, not today, tomorrow, they will shut down. So I think we have to see in more perspective, according to our understanding, even if anti-dumping comes with 15-20%, we feel manufacturing setup will survive for some time and then become self-sustained when we develop our own value chain, right from, say polysilicon to ingot making to wafer making. Maybe you need 30% duty. 30-35%, someone says 40% duty. So this is again the other side of the coin. But if you see the one side duty coming from how we can be so dependent on government, these are things which we have to see in rice perspective and see that overall value chain is strengthened in the country. This was one point I wanted to say. Second point, quality, I think Rahul has already addressed a lot. People are unfortunately compromising a lot on the quality, starting from back sheet, maybe EV also. Other countries are very efficient in controlling cost of manufacturing because of skill, but what is the quality? We have seen, again, if I tell you something, we sell EV and back sheet and sell to many, almost all the company here in India, especially EV and backsheet. But our own company had bought some EV a lot from some companies and they rejected. They said these are the problems. So these are few facts which probably are quite alarming. I will touch upon again on DCR because I have again the pain and gain of both from DCR, because DCR helped company, helped India. And there are a lot of schemes coming from Gujarat, like Shishti, Kusum, so many others, they are under DCR. And that is the reason, in spite of some problem from government policies, especially east market, especially west and central India market was still growing and they've grown. And I think they have done better than what was expected a quarter back. We are able to sell only in India if it is this year. We will not be able to compete sell price in India versus any country you take, Taiwan or Korea or including China. So DCR is helping manufacturer. And I think we wish that it should be there in some or the other way, in some pocket, so that at least breathing keep on coming. Thank you.